Here I am in test lab, and I've just recorded some torsional data using zebra tape on a rotating shaft. I'm going to look at the data here. It was 188 pulses per revolution. Oh, this data looks a little odd. It looks like I have a dip every revolution of my shaft. I can see that there is a strong second order component in my torsional data. But I have a problem. And this problem was probably caused by zebra tape that overlapped as it was wrapped around the shaft, causing a large gap between two successive pulses. So it appears to momentarily slow down. Using the time signal calculator, so under tools here, I can turn on time signal calculator for 26 tokens. I can take this data, put it in the input basket, and there are some correction algorithms I can try and run on it. So I got my data here, and of course you can zoom in the lower part from the upper. And I go to the formula section and I'll hit FX here. And under the TACO settings, there is something called zebra moments to RPM. I'll select that. The formula asks me what channel I want to perform this on, channel 1 in this case, CH1. And pulses per rev is supposed to be 188. And there's some other settings for minimum, maximum frequency and RPM, and how many revolutions to use to figure out where this overlapping joint is. And I can even tell it there's, if I had zebra tape that didn't quite cover the diameter and I had to use two or three pieces of tape, I can note that as well. And I will put an ID here, corrected, hopefully, and I'll hit calculate. New channel here, I'll display it. And I can see there's a lot less of a dip. Maybe I can overlay that with my old data by changing the curves per window here to 2. And look, that's good. This large dip, which caused the shaft to appear like it was momentarily slowing down each revolution, has now been removed from my data. And that is how you use the function zebra moments to RPM